Henry and Gordon were sulky. Thomas had gone to work on his own branch line. They couldn't stay in the shed until it was time to find the coaches at the platform anymore. They had to shunt them themselves. It was autumn, and the weather had become bitterly cold.
Getting up early, shunting around coaches, and in the wind too. Tender engines shouldn't have to endure this.
Henry quite agrees. One warm, dry October evening, Henry's crew came with important news. "There's a circus coming to the island," grinned the driver, "and the fat controller has asked us to pull it." Henry was excited.
Gordon sniffed. "Who would want to pull a rotten old circus anyway?" he scoffed.
"You're just jealous," laughed Henry.
"No, I'm not. My driver told me all about that circus. It's haunted."
"You're having me on."
"It's no joke. They go around with animals, like tigers, lions, snakes, elephants. He said that the animals aren't treated well at all. They don't like doing tricks. Once, an elephant tried to escape from it. He ran away and the keeper chased him. The elephant hid in the tunnel and stayed where he was, so the keeper followed him inside. Neither of them ever came out."
"Oi! Get back here!"
And so, whenever that circus comes back to town, the elephant comes with it, still trying to escape.
"What utter nonsense! Ghost elephants! I've never heard anything so ridiculous."
"Fine, be like that. But don't say I didn't warn you. That circus is cursed."
"And I'm the King of England. All this extra work's driven you mad." "Cursed circus. Pah!" The circus soon arrived. Henry forgot to be cross about shunting and took great pride in arranging the special trucks. James was jealous.
"Why should you get the circus train? Surely they'd want a splendid sight like me to pull them. Something more eye-catching."
"A pity you don't have any red in your face. Then you could be their new clown."
"Hey!"
"Trust me, James. You wouldn't want to pull the circus. It's haunted."
Haunted?
"Gordon says so. Didn't you hear him last night?"
I must have been asleep."
"Shh, shh. They've got undead elephants. Listen."
Doesn't that sound like a spirit?
Yeah, silly Gordon. Silly Gordon.
We need to be back on the mainland by sunrise. Henry, you don't mind staying up just a little while longer, do you?
Of course not! This'll be one of the headlamps for Gordon.
Henry was making good time, until he saw a man with a red flag waving him down.
What is it? I can't be kept waiting.
James says there's something blocking the tunnel. Please, bring these men here to unblock it.
But, I can't. I look silly pushing them and pulling the circus.
Then it's a good thing no one's armed to see you, isn't it? Come on, fetch some trucks for them.
Thanks a lot, James. You're going to make me late. He's an odd one. No two ways about it.
Right, let's get to work, lads.
And do be quick about it.
Yeah, like I want to be out of bed in the middle of the night.
What's the holdup? And what was that about, lads? And where's your tools?
Never you mind about your stupid tools. What about us?
What about you?
Look, we went to the pocket and started to dig it away, but it grunted and moved.
Go on, get over it. That's rubbish.
It isn't rubbish. It's big and alive. We aren't going in there again. So there.
All right, then. Henry will push this there blockage out of the way.
I don't want to go in. And you think I do?
But we must. We've got to clear the line.
They're all just sleepy as all, hearing and seeing things. silly workman.
Sir?
I'm no staying in this truck all night. We'll ride in the brake van. Leave the trucks in the siding.
And don't come back!
What's the matter, Henry? It looks like you've seen a ghost.
That's not funny. I saw it. I saw it.
Saw the elephant? You actually believed me? It's just a story, Henry. You need some sleep, my dear engine. You aren't seeing straight.
Gordon says there's no such thing as ghosts. But we know what we saw, don't we?